I'm Cody Clark, and this is your Daily Herald Movie Roundup. Our first film this week is The Errand of Angels, which goes where no LDS movie has gone before by focusing on sister missionaries, the young female members of The Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints, who go out into the world to spread their faith two by two, just like their male counterparts. It's a sincere and pleasant reminder that LDS films can discuss LDS culture without burying their good intentions beneath a protective coating of winking self-analysis and caricature. Sister Taylor is a new missionary in Austria, fresh-faced and fresh out of Brigham Young University.
I don't know if I have what it takes to be a good missionary.
Don't worry, you'll be fine.
Yeah.
Congratulations.
Cool.
She's ready to change the world, or at least the part of it that resides in the land of Mozart and Edelweiss. As a new missionary, Taylor has good experiences and bad ones. Her first companion is a perfect fit, but her second one seems determined to disagree with her about everything. Writer and director Christian Vuiza makes these interactions seem natural. Without belaboring the point, he lets you see the difficulty of being assigned to live with a stranger and cooperate at all times in a largely self-directed endeavor. The overarching plot is ultimately limited to Sister Taylor's coming to terms with herself as a missionary. It's not exactly the stuff of Casablanca or even of God's Army. But the series of somewhat mundane challenges, interspersed with minor victories and small disappointments, feels like it's probably pretty close to the actual experience of most missionaries. If you're not in the mood for preaching, then rock and roll might be the ticket. The Rocker is the first big feature film for Rainn Wilson, who plays Prissy Dwight Schrute on The Office. In The Rocker, Wilson is a heavy metal drummer who gets booted from his band just before a huge record deal launches them to stardom. 20 years later, he's bitter but not washed up, and his nephew's garage band, wouldn't you know it, needs a skins basher. Christina Applegate plays the mother of one of his new bandmates, so if you've ever dreamed about seeing Dwight Schrute put the moves on Kelly Bundy, then run, don't walk, to the ticket counter. There's no romance in the long shots, but this is also a movie about living your dreams. They're football dreams, and our unlikely dreamer is a young preteen girl with a killer arm who might be ready to turn the world of Pop Warner football upside down. Based on actual events, The Long Shots is the first film to be directed by Limp Bizkit singer Fred Durst. The young quarterback is played by Kiki Palmer, star of Aquila and the Bee, and Ice Cube has the Walter Matthau Memorial role as the beer-swilling lout who brings the movie's bad news ballers together. The House Bunny is probably a bit of a long shot for anyone who doesn't own both Legally Blonde movies. This one has scary movie stalwart Anna Faris as a very blonde wannabe Playboy playmate who gets booted from the House of Hef because she's 27. If the Playboy Mansion doesn't want you, then it must be time for college, or at least for the most woebegone sorority house on campus. The loser denizens of Zeta Alpha Zeta haven't got a clue about makeup or clothes, so it must be time for slut lessons. Finally, there's Death Race, which takes some of the ideas from Sylvester Stallone's Death Race 2000 and basically runs them over and then does what it wants to do. What it wants to do is have people drive fast and try to kill each other. The drivers are prison inmates, and the winner gets a full pardon, but only if everyone else is, you guessed it, dead. If you like Jason Statham, star of the Transporter films, then you'll probably enjoy him here. If you don't know who Jason Statham is, then consider saving your money, and we'll have something brand new for you next week.